Hello and welcome to my channel. If you are interested in CNC machines and want to see how I designed and built a totally overkill hobby CNC router, watch this till the end. Because in this video, I would like to give you an overview of a new CNC router that I currently built. I will explain a little bit my CNC background, the motivation for this build, walk you through the main design features, and highlight the key specifications. This is already the sixth CNC router that I have designed and built. I've started my CNC journey a few years ago with a commercially available router kit, mainly to make my own parts for scale modeling hobby. But in parallel, I used it for some woodworking projects and very quickly felt the need to make wooden parts and precise parts out of aluminum and plastic on two separate machines, simply because of the mess. That's when I designed and built my first CNC mill out of UHPC. And designing and building hobby CNCs actually became my new hobby. The very rigid UHPC router was perfect for milling precise metal and plastic parts, and a very good machine for everything that was about to come. You know, machines build machines. I haven't made a lot of videos during the build of this CNC router, but I believe these pictures here already give you a good flavor about what kind of machine I have built. So the next step was to replace the commercial CNC kit with my own design. I tried to address all the flaws that I have noticed in the kit, and the result was a very sturdy woodworking router. I started with a bed frame out of extruded profiles, but rather than mounting the linear rails directly on the profiles, like in the kit, I added a 20mm thick aluminum plate in which I milled the mounting surfaces. I left like half a millimeter stock and milled the final contour after assembly of the complete frame. This had to be done in two steps because of the size of the frame, and it took forever to realign everything properly on the machine. But the result were perfectly parallel mounting surfaces. The main part of the gantry is a C-shaped plate, which is bolted from two sides to the side plates of the gantry. This gives a very good lateral stiffness without the need for any supporting brackets. Lateral stiffness, you know, is the weak spot of most gantry style routers, and this design proved to be quite effective for that. But plates don't have a good torsional rigidity, so I designed the entire gantry as a torsion box. The Z-axis is a very sturdy box with fixed rails and moving carriers. With this design, you can move the spindle above the gantry bottom and use the full height of the gantry. In return, the gantry can be lower and therefore stiffer. The router was then placed in its final location, and the enclosure was built mainly out of aluminum profiles and plexi. The fixture plate is made out of acetyl and has a combination of M8 threads and vacuum channels, so you can basically use all sorts of work holding. Overall, a very satisfying machine with good versatility and performance. But the reason why I'm going to replace it now is that I wanted to have a little bit more work area. See, my shop is in the basement of our house and is a kitchen-style combination of cabinets and benchtops. This was an awesome design when my hobby was still scale modeling, but it is not so great when you have a lot of machines, especially CNC machines, because the depth of the benchtop basically determines the size of your machines. But I reorganized the shop last year, rearranged the cabinets, and modified the benchtop. And with this, I could also increase the size of my woodworking router from previously 900 by 500 mm to now 1250 by 700 mm. Especially the increase in width was important to me, because now I have the possibility to make cabinets on it. Although I am not sure that I ever will. As you can see, it is still a tight fit, and the enclosure takes the entire depth of the benchtop. But the second limitation that I have is the overall size of the workshop, and that is given, and this is now the best compromise in size. As I've said, the performance of the previous router was excellent, so I decided to go again for this build with the same design. And the gantry and the Z-axis are basically just a scaled copy. But for the machine bed, I went in a totally different direction this time, replacing the frame out of extruded profiles with a frame out of solid aluminum bars. The reason behind this I will explain in the next video where I assemble this frame. Just so much in advance, it has something to do with the sagging. Another benefit is that the machine will have a rather heavy base now of approximately 250 kilo, and the ratio between the fixed and the moving mass is now about 2:1. So here are then the basic specs of what I'm going to build. The axis travel is about 1290 by 710 by 950 millimeters. And the work area, as I mentioned, 1250 by 700 millimeters. And the gantry clearance, so between the fixture plate and the bottom of the gantry, is 155 millimeters. Overall weight of this beast is around 370 kilos. The heart of the router will be a liquid-cooled Spinogy X30 automatic tool change spindle with 4 kilowatts. It has a 4-pole motor, a max speed of 30,000 RPM and an SK30 interface. Some time ago I have replaced the 2.2 kilowatt spindle on my UHPC router with this spindle, and I'm so happy with the quality and the performance that I will use it on this one as well. Spinogy is a young German spindle maker that entered the market a few years ago with their 2.2 kilowatt X22, and they have since continually expanded their lineup. The build quality and their service is top-notch, and I have not regretted switching to their products. Other than that, the ball screws will be from TBI, ground to C5 precision, with zero backlash double nuts. Linear rails are from Hiwin in size 25, with preloaded carriers and extra dust seals. The axis motors are 400 watt IHSV servos from JMC with an integrated driver. So rapids will be around 15 meter per minute. This kind of precise linear components are not really necessary for a mere woodworking router, but I would like to have this machine as well as a backup for an occasional metal part that wouldn't fit on my other machine. The CNC controller will be built as well by myself. In fact, I have already started on it. Basis for this is an Eding CNC 760 control board. I have the same one on my other router and it works just fine. I use Eding ever since I started my CNC hobby and it works well for me. No reason to change the system. And this already sums up what I wanted to show in this video. It's the start of a series where I will document the complete assembly of the router, including the machining of the components, so that you can actually see how these self-designed and built machines actually perform. And in each video, I will explain in more detail the design considerations of the featured elements, like the machine bed, the gantry, the Z-axis, the vacuum fixture plate, and so on. And in a later video, I will also dive into the build of the CNC controller and the enclosure. I know many people hesitate to show this because of the electrics, but I believe it might be interesting, and the controller is an important element of a CNC, so not showing this feels kind of wrong. So, if you like the design and want to see how all this comes together, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you don't miss the next video, seeing me struggling with ultra-heavy aluminum bars, constantly questioning my design choices. Also, please leave a comment below what you think about this project in general. And since this is my first YouTube video, any suggestions for improvements are welcomed as well. Stay tuned and see you next time.